Be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, Father.
Today we celebrate the Passion of Saint John the Baptist. This day we pray for birthday wishes, for good health, for Tessa Di Mello. We also, in a very special way, we pray for all those who are working abroad, be it in our own families or who we know. We remember them during this Eucharist. Let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask that this Mary, a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who willed that Saint John the Baptist should go ahead of your Son, both in his birth and in his death, grant that as he died a martyr for truth and justice, we too may find heart for the confession of what you teach. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers, your faith has been a great comfort to us in the middle of our troubles and sorrows. Now we can breathe again as you are still holding firm in the Lord. How can we thank God enough for you, for all the joy we feel before our God on your account? We are earnestly praying night and day to be able to see you face to face again and make up any shortcomings in your faith. May God our Father himself and our Lord Jesus Christ make it easy for us to come to you. May the Lord be generous in increasing your love and make you love one another and the whole human race as much as we love you. And may he so confirm your hearts in holiness that you be blameless in the sight of our God and Father when our Lord Jesus Christ comes with all his saints. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response is, fill us with your love that we may rejoice.
Fill us with your love that we may rejoice.
You turn men back into dust and say, go back, sons of men. To your eyes a thousand years are like yesterday, come and gone, no more than a watch in the night. Response,
fill us with your love that we may rejoice.
Make us know the shortness of our life, that we may gain wisdom of heart. Lord, relent. Is your anger forever? Show pity to your servants. Response,
fill us with your love that we may rejoice.
In the morning, fill us with your love. We shall exult and rejoice all our days. Let the favor of the Lord be upon us. Give success to the work of our hands. Response,
fill us with your love that we may rejoice.
gospel acclamation, kindly stand. Alleluia, alleluia. I call you friends, says the Lord, because I have made known to you everything I've learned from my Father. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Herod has sent to have John arrested and had him chained up in the prison because of Herodias, his brother Philip's wife, whom he had married. For John had told Herod, "It is against the law for you to have your brother's wife." As for Herodias, she was furious with him and wanted to kill him. But she was not able to, because Herod was afraid of John, knowing him to be a good and holy man, and gave him his protection. When he had heard him speak, he was greatly perplexed, and yet he liked to listen to him. An opportunity came on Herod's birthday, when he gave a banquet for the nobles of his court, for his army officers, and for the leading figures in Galilee. When the daughters of this same Herodias came in and danced, she delighted Herod and his guests. So the king said to the girl, "Ask me anything you like, and I will give it to you." And he swore her on an oath, "I will give you anything you ask, even half my kingdom." She went out and said to her mother, What shall I ask for?" She replied, "The head of John the Baptist." The girl hurried straight back to the king and made her request, "I want you to give me John the Baptist's head, here and now on a dish." The king was deeply distressed, but thinking of the oath he had sworn and of his guest, he was reluctant to break his word to her. So the king at once sent out one of the bodyguards with orders to bring John's head. The man went off and beheaded him in prison. Then he brought the head on a dish and gave it to the girl. The girl gave it to her mother. When John's disciples heard about this, they came and took his body and laid it in a tomb. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Gospel of today teaches us two messages. First message, very clear: if we breed anger, if we breed jealousy, if we breed lust, without grace, it will surely end in murder. We take the example of Cain and Abel. They breeded anger and jealousy among the brothers. And the end result was murder of innocent Abel. The second example is of David. He had lust feeling towards Uriah's wife. Uriah used to always help David. But at the end, David kills this person, innocent person. Third example is today's gospel, Herodias and John the Baptist. Herodias was angry with John the Baptist. The end result, a planned murder of John the Baptist. It teaches us, if we have anger, hatred, any other feeling, to get rid of this feeling at once. The second thing that the gospel teaches us, that death and suffering of innocent does not portray defeat. The death of John the Baptist is a precursor to the death of Jesus. And if we go to see in the life of Jesus, the passion of Jesus or today's gospel, we see great people like even Jesus, they not only become human, but as human, they suffer every difficult feeling which we ourselves suffer, like moments of injustice, powerless, in front of powerful, helpless, unwanted, lonely moments, rejection, not going as per our plans, or even broken relationship. And the human tendency among us in these moments is to withdraw from people, to hide ourselves. But if we go to see in the life of Jesus, as well as in John the Baptist, there are few things that they do. Like Jesus, he prays in the Garden of Gethsemane. Second is, he takes courage. Even John the Baptist and Jesus, they both take courage. They ask them, whom are you searching for? Jesus asked the soldiers, whom are you searching for? When Peter cuts one of the soldiers' ear, Jesus heals them. People may do bad to us, but he continues with his good. The third, fourth question he asked the people, like, no, once they slap him, he asked them, why did you hit me? Why are you beating me? If I have done anything wrong, you tell me. He questions them. And both John the Baptist and Jesus stands for truth. And the last, like, no, in Gospel of John, Jesus mentions two words. One is, I thirst. I thirst always to do what is God's will in my life. Always to do what is right in my life. Always to do what is truth in my life. And second is, it is accomplished. Means God's presence is not only there with us in our happy moments, but even in moments when we are in difficulty. So it's a challenge for us to learn from Jesus as well as John the Baptist that even in suffering, God is always present in our lives. Amen.
Offertory hymn number 138 on page 38. 138, page 38.
Sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Let us pray. Through these offerings which we bring you, Lord, grant that we may make straight your path, as taught by that voice crying in the desert, Saint John the Baptist, who powerfully sealed his teaching by the shedding of his blood. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. Through Christ our Lord. In his precursor, St. John the Baptist, we praise your great glory, for you consecrated him for a singular honor among those born of women. His birth brought great rejoicing, even in the womb he left for joy as the coming of human salvation. He alone of all the prophets pointed out the lamp of redemption, and to make holy the flowing waters, he baptized the very author of baptism and was privileged to bear him supreme witness by the shedding of his blood. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread and, giving thanks, broke it. he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Philip Neri our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Let's pray for anyone who has died in our families. We also remember Luisa Teres. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed apostles, saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we are merited to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Together say the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not fall into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a meaningful sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Communion, let us sing hymn number 458 on page 150. Hymn number 458 on page 150.
John answered and said, "He must increase, but I must decrease." Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, as we celebrate the heavenly birth of Saint John the Baptist, that we may revere what it signifies, the saving sacrament we have received, and even more may rejoice at its clear effects in us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Glorify the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God. Hymn number 209 on page 65. 209, page 65.
Give me all that my life, give me all.